Joe Ricards here, shooting from Sumy, Ukraine today. Let me ask you, have you seen all these gorgeous Ukrainian Russian women online? You know, these marriage agency dating websites, the mail order bride websites, as we know them as, and thought, you know what, this is just one big scam from beginning to end. Or have you thought, have you wondered, maybe, I wonder if there are actually some beautiful younger Ukrainian Russian women that are just lonely, looking for a good man to settle down with and have a family, because that's so huge for them here. Well, if you've wondered what is the truth on this very big question, then let me show you what I uncovered. Because I wondered this very same question when I came to the Ukraine. I was so suspicious. And so what I did is I thought, how can I truly uncover the truth on this very important question to us Western guys looking for love in Ukraine or Russia? So what I did was I went on a quest to find honest Ukrainian ladies to interview and ask them what is the truth on this subject and other subjects as well. So that's what you're going to see in this video series here today, is you're going to see and hear from honest Ukrainian ladies about this topic. These ladies are, some are married, some are single with kids, single without children. All of them I know. Most of them have never been with a marriage agency, and all of them are completely open and honest on camera. So I promise you, you're going to be shocked by what you hear in this video series. It's not what you think in most cases. So I hope you enjoy. I hope you get a big education out of this, and enjoy. Hi, Zhenya.
Hi, Joseph.
Listen, I want to thank you so much for agreeing to talk to me today about this tough subject of the mail order bride business and be open and honest with me. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. I'm glad to be here.
Thanks again. Okay, first question I think I would ask you is, this business, this marriage agency business in Ukraine, the mail order bride business as it's unfortunately called, what's your opinion of it? You think it's good business, bad business? What's your opinion?
I think it's bad business because it contains a lot of lie. And also, people want to make money, and I didn't know about a lot of great results of this business. I know about broken hearts, mm-hmm. and that people were not truly
with each other. They weren't honest with each other.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So. What do you think is the root of the problem, the cause of the problem? Is it the lady? Is it the, you know, bad lady, bad Western man? Mm-hmm. Or what do you think is the root cause of it?
I think men and women often they don't have good motives to use this business to build their life. And also this agency want to make money, so they are not interested to help people to build good mm-hmm. marriage.
They're just after the money.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. On that note, we were talking off camera, you have some personal stories of friends that applied to be a translator and stuff. Can you share that with me?
Yeah, I have a few friends. They wanted to be translators for these agencies. And
in Sumy here?
Yeah, in Sumy. Mm-hmm. And my friends didn't like to work with agency because agency wanted that my friends will lie about, for example, women, her story, her characteristic, and also...
Can I just clarify with that? Yeah. So you mean when she was applying to be a client, she was coming to mm-hmm. an agency and she puts down her personal profile, mm-hmm. they yeah. tell her, okay, write this and this, and they change it. Is that what you mean?
Yes.
Yes, okay. Mm-hmm. I just wanted to make sure you understood
mm-hmm. that. Okay. And also, my friends needed to translate very intimate answers, intimate questions and answers uh-huh. for people who wanted to know something very deep.
Uh-huh. So, like, can I just be straight up, like, sexual content?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And
so, my friends... felt like ugly, and they didn't want to do this.
Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you. And did your friends tell you, talk about the fact that they would be translating for many different women, many different profiles, like many different beautiful women, and talking, not just talking about themselves, they would be translating and pretending there are many other women?
No, I don't know if it were a lot of women or one. Mm-hmm.
Oh,
I don't
okay.
know.
Okay, mm-hmm. okay, thank you. What about, let me ask you, so you think this agency business is mostly bad, you say?
Mostly bad.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And have you heard any... Have you heard any good stories about marriage agencies?
I heard good stories when agency was truly
an honest agency.
Honestly, honest agency.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Uh huh. And so you've heard a story of an honest agency
about marriage.
Mm-hmm. Uh huh. So you think there are some?
Yeah, there are some.
How many do you think? Like, I know you're just kind of guessing, but like, a little bit or a lot of good agencies?
What do you think? I think a little bit.
A little, a few.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Diamonds in the rough, as we say. Okay. And let me ask you this. So is there, do you think, many beautiful single Ukrainian ladies in the Ukraine?
A lot.
There's a lot.
Mm-hmm.
A lot. And why do you think that is? Why is there so many beautiful single Ukrainian ladies? I was shocked when I came here to see that. Mm-hmm. There is actually many single ones.
Yeah, it's a pity. I noticed that very often men, their attitude is lazy, and men are not confident and to lead family. They are not ready to lead family and have responsible for different questions about life of family. And also, they are not brave to have big goal to realize themselves in profession. And also, very often they drink often, and they are aggressive and not faithfulness to.
Really, they cheat. Have many women.
Many women. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And those many women don't know about this.
Right.
Yeah, so that's why. Of course, women too. There are a lot of women who are not faithful. So often Ukrainian men drunk, like almost every day. And
wow.
They are not faithful, they cheap, like changing
cheat.
Women.
Uh-huh.
Cheat, yeah.
Uh-huh.
And... women don't trust men
because they're not faithful.
Yeah, uh-huh. Yeah.
What about open versus closed? Is the Ukrainian man pretty open or is he closed? What do you think?
They are closed. Yeah, they are inside themselves. It's very hard sometimes to understand some men, like what he think about. And I think men don't trust women too.
Really? Why doesn't the man trust the woman?
Because woman, very often, attitude of woman is without respect to men. And it's very painful for men. So they don't want to be open.
But why is the woman not respecting him?
Because...
Is there a reason?
It's a circle, yeah.
Uh-huh, vicious circle.
Yeah.
Uh-huh, because respect has to be earned. By your character,
yeah.
By what you do, your actions you take, right?
Yeah, no one want to be first.
Mm-hmm.
I will respect.
Uh-huh. And of course, that's important for a man to be respected.
It's the main,
woman.
I think.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. For a man, yeah. For us, it's very mm-hmm. important. Okay, so what I'm hearing from you is that there's a lot of beautiful single Ukrainian ladies,
mm-hmm.
genuinely looking
yeah.
to find a serious
yeah.
man to marry, but she just can't find a good Ukrainian man to marry. Is that what I'm hearing?
Yeah, it's true. It's our situation.
So why do you think Ukrainian women is resort to go to a marriage agency? Why are they looking for a Western man? What do you think?
Because I think they have hope that maybe Western men are stronger, are another, just to know who they are. Maybe there will be someone good and faithful.
So stronger, I heard you say, and faithful. What do you mean
yeah.
by stronger?
Stronger. For me, it's when men can take responsible for family. And he can control himself. And he loves to work, to care about his family. Mm-hmm. For me, it's strong man.
So he's a good provider, I'm hearing. He knows and he's focused on what he's doing in life.
And yeah, in a time of troubles, he will not drink and smoke and beat his woman, but he will have patience. Mm-hmm. He will go through difficult times together with his family. This is strong man.
Mm, that's a good definition of strong, I think. Okay, so she's hopeful that she'll meet a better Western man.
Yeah.
So you think that's why they go to the agencies. How many women do you think are going to the agencies are, you know, not pure intentions? So, for example, they're looking to find a rich man, and let's face it, times are tough in Ukraine. Mm-hmm. Are a lot of women looking to go to a Western man to get out of Ukraine for a better life and not after love?
I think a lot of women, because it's hard life without money, and they want just to have better life, to have comfort, and they don't think about their hearts. It's not, it began to be not so important in this hard life without money.
So a lot of them, you think, are going for the wrong intentions.
A lot of them, yes.
Mm-hmm. So the point to the Western man is we have to be very careful that we are with a genuine lady.
Yes. And with agency.
A good agency.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Careful, to be careful.
Which are few and far between.
Yes.
Not too many.
Okay. Yes.
Okay. Are you curious, and do you think other Ukrainian ladies are curious, why are so many Western men coming to the Ukraine in search of love and a wife?
Yeah, it's interesting. Why?
Mm-hmm. What do you think? What's the reason?
They want to find a good woman, and maybe in their countries it was hard for them. Maybe woman there is not what this man wants. Mm-hmm. And also I know that a woman in Ukraine is good.
Can you elaborate on that? Why is she good? I agree, they're amazing. Why are they good, and how are they maybe different from a Western woman?
I think they are very tender, and they want to love, and they know how to love. They want to be faithful, and maybe woman, foreign woman. Like the main goal of them are job and career.
Western woman.
Yeah.
Yeah. Spot on there.
Mm-hmm. So foreign men want family, want not strong woman. How to say not strong?
Western men.
Like she will be tender.
Yeah, like a partner that's family-oriented, as opposed to career-oriented, is what the Western
like
men
she will not be stronger than men. She will not behave this. Uh-huh.
She won't try to emasculate him, kind of be stronger than
him.
Yeah. She lets him be the leader, the head of the family.
Yeah.
She's okay with that.
Yeah.
So traditional roles is what I'm hearing.
Yeah, and I think Ukrainian women look for this, but after hard times with men, Ukrainian women also began to be, to try to be stronger than
she
men.
She has to be, right?
And try to lead men. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, if the man doesn't lead, then she feels she must, I think.
Yeah. And sometimes it needs a lot of time to show a woman that man can lead, mm-hmm. and she will trust. It mm-hmm. needs time. And then she will be, like, smaller.
Mm-hmm. She will let him
woman.
Lead. Let
mm-hmm.
him lead.
Yeah.
It's by smaller, you mean she will let him lead
mm-hmm.
The family.
Yeah.
Okay. What is a Ukrainian woman looking for in a man? Can you paint a picture for me? What characteristics, how she wants her future husband to be?
Mm-hmm. I think they want that he will value her, mm-hmm. and he will be interested very much in who she are, what is inside her. He will be ready to talk with her about different, about all the things. And he will want to carry about family. He will work. He will be ready to ask for forgiveness if something will be not good.
Mm-hmm. If he makes a mistake, own up to it and ask her to forgive him.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Like this.
Okay. Yeah, that paints a good picture. Thank you. Jenny, let me ask you, what are the fears? What fears would you have if you were going to marry a Western man? Like, what do you think the fears are of the Ukrainian lady if she's going to marry a Western man?
As for me, I can afraid about mentality. Like, I don't know a lot of foreign men. I was born here and I know Ukrainian men. For me, it's usual. I feel like free mostly.
Yeah, you know his mindset.
Yeah,
how
yeah.
he thinks. And
but foreign men for me. Like, I don't know them. Maybe we will be in marriage and then I will have some surprises. Mm-hmm. His view on life, family, and we will be not united in this. And also, I can afraid maybe he will change his mind and he will leave me and he will be not faithful. This fears. Yeah, okay. Like this.
And what about going to the other country, going to his country? Anything about that?
If I will be sure in him, mm-hmm. we can go everywhere.
Okay, no problem. And your English is great, so you don't have this obstacle.
Yeah.
A lot of ladies don't have good English.
They can learn.
They can learn.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Okay.
So your fears are more around maybe he's not who he says he is.
Yeah.
Maybe when you get to know him more. So maybe your fear is to get married too quickly, maybe. Is that
this too.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay, thanks. Okay, now what about the roles of the Ukrainian wife versus the husband in the Ukraine? You know, what is the Ukrainian man's job or the man's job, husband's job versus the wife's role mm-hmm. job?
I think man has to lead family. And not woman. And also he has to work. She also can work if she want. And for Ukrainian situation, it will be good that everybody will work. But if man has a good job, she can be free from work. So he need to think for future, about future of the family, what will be later. And he has to be responsible about different decision of the family. And the woman has to be support for her husband mm-hmm. and care about home, different stuff. And also, I think they are both have to train children to grow, to care about children, mm-hmm. to explain everything about life for children, not only women, mm-hmm. both.
Right. Yeah. Okay, that's great. And now the woman's role in a marriage in Ukraine?
Yeah, I told her to care about home. Mm-hmm. If she wants, she can work. She has to support him mm-hmm. to cook, but he can like to cook also.
So she would like him to maybe help out in the house, is that?
Yeah.
She cook sometimes and help out.
She has to cook every time, but if he likes, mm-hmm.
it's then good. It's okay.
Yeah, it's good. It's really good mm-hmm. if they enjoy together mm-hmm. to cook.
Yeah. Okay, so I'm here more traditional. Values, traditional roles mm-hmm. for marriage in the Ukraine.
Mm-hmm, yes. Mm-hmm.
Let me ask you, Jenya, if you could tell me a little bit about yourself, you know, how old you are, what you do for work, and just a little bit about mm-hmm. yourself.
Okay. I'm 28.
You're 28?
Yeah. And
wow, you look so young and beautiful.
Thanks. I'm a Christian, born again Christian.
Born again Christian.
9 years already. And 5 years I'm a minister in church.
Wow.
Yeah.
You're a minister in a church here in Sumy.
Yeah, in Sumy from September. Now it's summer. Okay. So almost 1 year.
Okay.
Yeah, before I were in Kyiv and in Donetsk.
Tell me a little bit about how you got into ministry in the church and what you do.
When I began to be Christian, I felt that I want to help people to know God. And also, when I was small, my parents were divorced, mm-hmm. and I felt what it is to lost father as a father. So when I came to God, I found that I have a great father, like my heavenly father. And I felt that it's the biggest treasure of my life, that he found me, I found him. Mm-hmm. And I know what it is when this connection begin to exist between father and children. And I want to help a lot of people to find their father, real parent. Mm-hmm. And this dream grew in me, and ministers noticed that I want to fellowship with people, to study Bible with people a lot. And after finishing my university, they proposed me to work for church. And 4 or 5 years I work like this, study Bible with girls, organized different times for people.
Oh, that's fantastic.
That's really that's fantastic for me too.
Yeah, you love your job.
I love it. Yeah.
That's awesome. What about, let's talk about religion in Ukraine for a moment. Most of Ukraine is Orthodox.
Ukrainian most,
Orthodox.
Yes.
Okay. And what percent would you say is Orthodox versus Protestant?
I think 90% are Orthodox.
Orthodox Christians.
But also a lot of them are not truly Orthodox.
Okay.
They name themselves Orthodox, but they are not faithful to convictions. Mm-hmm. And like we're Christians, but they are not Christians. Uh-huh. Like this.
I see.
Protestants. Very little percent.
Very little Protestant.
Yeah, I think yes.
Mm-hmm. I was shocked to see that there are Baptist churches in Ukraine and that there is a Pentecostal and different Protestant churches, although little, mm-hmm. not too many of them.
Yeah.
But I understand it's Ukraine is actually, and the Protestant churches are growing the most in the world, I heard.
Yeah, they're growing. You mean it's fast growing?
Fast growing, yes.
I think not the fastest, like not the most fast. I heard about different countries where it's more fast. Uh-huh. But I think a lot of people looking for God here.
Mm-hmm. Zhenya, we're in June 2016 right now, and times are tough since the mm-hmm. war started. Mm-hmm. And Maidan, right? January 2013?
Yeah. It's hard.
Mm-hmm. It's a time of war over in Donetsk and on the eastern border to Russia. But the war is just segmented over there. The rest of Ukraine is not at war, right? The Western world thinks, the country's at war, but it's
no,
not.
No, we're sitting here.
We're sitting here in Sumy, Ukraine, and everything's good. Everything's good in Kiev and Kharkov and everywhere else in Ukraine except mm-hmm. for the Donetsk region,
yes.
right?
Yes.
Maybe paint a picture. What is life in the Ukraine like? In this time of economic uncertainty with the war going on right now, what is the economic situation for the average Ukrainian mm-hmm. person? How much money they make, and what is life like? If you could tell me.
I think it's a very difficult times for Ukraine. And what I saw in Sumy that money, what people have for the month from their work. It's very little money, like 2,000 hryvnias per month.
And it's 25 to 1 to the USD right now.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So they need to have gardens with, like to grow vegetables, to have their own food. Mm-hmm. It's more cheaper way.
So most people have gardens in the Ukraine, so they don't have to buy
very big produce. Gardens, and it's hard to carry about it. People are very tired about
a lot of work.
Yeah.
And so what is the average salary? 2,000 hryvnia per month is about the average salary in Sumy?
Yes.
And what does like a doctor, say a doctor or a lawyer, make per month?
I have friends, doctors, and I heard that it's not a big difference from 2,000.
So a little bit more than 2,000
a little bit more, maybe 3, but not more. Between 2 and 3.
Wow, so even an education that takes you 7 years to get, you don't make much more money.
Yeah, sometimes your education means nothing here.
Which is interesting, because that's what it was like in communist times, right? In communism, everybody made the same money, everybody had the same life. And so that's kind of the same in that respect, economically.
Maybe the same, but it's very hard to, like, even if doctors have their some money, and other people have less.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So how do people survive? They make gardens, and so they don't have to buy produce. Families live together; they stick mm-hmm. together too, right?
Yeah.
During tough times.
They trying to not spend a lot of money for what they want, mm-hmm. just to trying to live, to have food. Like this.
You know, so with times being so tough, you know, one of the fears of the Western man is. That the woman is just looking to get out of the Ukraine. So she'll latch on to any guy to get out of the Ukraine for a better life. Mm-hmm. Maybe a passport. What are your thoughts? Like how many women are like that, just want to get out of the Ukraine, you know, and would marry a Western man for the wrong reasons? Is it a little bit? Is it a lot? What do you
think?
A lot. A lot?
Yeah, a lot.
So you have to be very careful of that.
Careful, yeah. You need to know person inside, and of course it's a temptation when you see some man with money, even if you are a good person and you want to have good family, you in any way you will think about money. But I believe that foreign men can find a good woman even if she think about money, but desire to have good family will be more inside her.
Mm-hmm. More and important than money.
Yeah, and he need to see this. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What do you think? What tips would you give for the Western man? How can you find these, you know, few genuine Ukrainian ladies and separate them from the gold diggers, as we call it, the ones that are just trying to get out of the Ukraine mm-hmm. for a better life? Truly a woman that's looking for love, connection, and family.
I think that woman will be interested in heart of man, like who he is. She will enjoy times of fellowship, conversations. She will try sincere to support him.
To support him?
Yeah, to support uh-huh. him. She uh-huh. will be glad to have times together. Mm-hmm. He will see that she's a little bit happy. Uh-huh. Yeah.
So he should be able to see that she's into him. She likes
yeah,
him.
Yeah, she will and write sometimes first, ask something, maybe a lot of questions. Mm-hmm. She will be interested.
Mm-hmm. Jenya, let me ask you. Mm-hmm. I think Western men, you know, a lot of them come to the Ukraine and the cultural differences and the language differences and barriers are so great that they blow it. They blow their chance with a lovely lady, you know. And so I think we need some tips, any suggestions or tips you would have for how the Western man should pursue his mm-hmm. lady in the mm-hmm. Ukraine.
I think first he needs to be accurate and try to know more what kind of woman she is, what she likes, how she feels herself free and defended. He has...
So try to get to know her.
Yeah, yeah.
Ask questions about her, be interested in her. Okay.
Yeah. He has not to have a lot of expectations from her. Mm-hmm. And he has to be natural and show himself who he is. Mm-hmm.
So be real.
Yeah, be real. That okay. she can feel, she can trust him. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Great advice. Yes. Uh-huh. And how about on a date? Say he shows up to take her out for the first time. Mm-hmm. What he should do, how he should behave?
I think first date, he needs to know her without presents, flowers. Maybe she doesn't like flowers on the first date and presents. Maybe it's a lot. It's like
maybe it's
buying.
Too much.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Maybe she likes small presents or big, and he has to like be accurate. Be like nice clothes.
Dress nice?
Yeah, mm-hmm. dress nice. Mm-hmm. Shaved.
Of course.
Good smell. Mm-hmm. And
smile, you said?
Yeah, and be himself, be free mm-hmm. and funny and...
Sense
and
of humor?
He, yeah,
funny
yeah, yeah.
And, important?
And he will know what to do next. Mm-hmm. Not going through some list, present and different points. Like, mm-hmm. we cannot be the same. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, I understand you. And okay, so that's the first date. And then what about the second date, the third date? Mm-hmm. How that should unfold? And maybe if you could talk about touching and mm-hmm. physical touch, mm-hmm. You know, and kind of pursuing a relationship, how the Ukrainian lady likes this to be. Slow or quickly or mm-hmm. what?
I think he has to be open with her about his like what he wants from this relationship. Mm-hmm. What is his goal for this relationship? Why he want these dates?
Mm-hmm. So is he sincere? Ask this
yes.
question. She wants to know if he's sincere.
Yeah.
Am I right?
Yeah.
Serious, I mean. Like
yes.
his intention is to have a long relationship and hopefully
yeah.
end up in marriage.
That she will know mm-hmm. what is for him.
So he should be very transparent about this up front, in mm-hmm. the beginning.
Yeah, I think okay. I understand you. I think yes.
yes.
Also, I forgot to tell that I think it will be good to say to her what he noticed good in her. Some good words.
Complimentary.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Compliment
yeah.
her beauty, maybe?
But sincere compliment.
Yes, of course. And what about complimenting her beauty?
Yes.
She
it
likes
will be
this.
Good, yes. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But not a lot.
Right, not too much. Okay.
Yeah.
And what about the physical part, again?
Physical part, yes.
Because I know there's some differences in our culture, the Western world and Ukraine lady, what she wants, expects.
For me, people doesn't have to be fast in this, not to hurry in this, because if they will be married, they will be free to be together in physical relationship, mm-hmm. and before they are not married, it will be good.
Our soup has arrived. Спасибо большое.
To hold themselves. From very close, like touching, I mean, it will connect them emotionally, but maybe they will not know each other first. And this emotional connection will be a problem to think about they like each other really or not like. Understand?
I think maybe you're saying, if I'm understanding you correctly, yes. I heard you say that if you rush the physical connection relationship too quickly, it's confuses the heart and the mind as to what is really this
good
relationship. Is what you mean?
Yes.
Okay, super.
Yes.
And specifically, how does a Ukrainian woman, my question specifically is, the Ukrainian woman wants not the man to touch her hand, touch her on the first date, wants to go slow, second date, third date. What is the time frame where you maybe hold hands?
Mm-hmm.
Slowly, first date, second date, third date, average woman. I know people are different, but what do you think?
Maybe if they like each other and they see they like each other, they feel they like each other. Mm-hmm. So maybe third date, he can hold her hand, for example.
Okay. So before that is really kind of inappropriate. And that's if she likes
it. For me, it's strange.
It's strange. Because I've noticed that us Western guys, we tend to be physical too quickly for Ukrainian ladies.
I think Ukrainian girls can afraid if they will not allow to touch them. Guys will leave them.
So sometimes they will allow it just because they don't want to give the wrong message.
Yes. Girls don't want to lost relationship. Maybe it will be good relationship, and they can afraid of touching, but they can allow this because they're afraid to lost relationship. Mm-hmm. But they will not be happy inside and feel good inside.
Mm-hmm. Well, our soup's getting cold, so I just want to thank you for the interview. You've been amazing.
Thanks, Joseph.
Thank you.
Great conversation.
Thank you. Okay, well, bon appetit.
Thanks.
Hey, it's Joe here. This video is for you if you were one of the countless guys that personally emailed me after watching our undercover video series, Love Me, Love Me Not. You asked me, Joe, how can I meet a real sincere Ukrainian lady? Can you point me in the direction of some good agencies? So I'm going to share with you my number one agency recommendation in this video. But before I do, let me share the backstory with you, how this came to be. You know, like you, I began my journey back in Canada at my computer, you know, looking at the myriad of websites with all these beautiful, incredible model-like beauties, Ukrainian beauties. And I found these sites are all the same, you know, and I was skeptical, but you know, I got my butt on a plane and flew to the Ukraine and just jumped in with both hands and feet. I quickly found out that these are some pretty shark infested waters, right? And I just wanted to know what's the truth. I wanted to know what is the path potentially for my success to meet a sincere, honest Ukrainian lady for marriage, right? For love and marriage. So I became kind of an undercover journalist and went to agency after agency after agency and went on a lot of dates, met with the owners, and my spidey senses were always tingling. I came to a point, honestly, where I gave up. I thought, this is not in the cards for me. And that's when I met this diamond in the rough agency. And I got so excited when I met them. At first, I was really skeptical, didn't believe. Their stats are unbelievable. 91% marriage success rate, over 800 marriages over their 16 years in the matchmaking business. But then I met with the owner and met with her a number of times, and she's so genuine, sincere. I met with their lead matchmaker, Tatiana, who she's been married over 30 years herself, and she loves her job matchmaking. And she's got a background in psychology. She meets with all the ladies personally. So they're genuine, sincere ladies. And that is huge. I think that's 80% of your success is to choose from a pool of ladies that are well vetted. And they're genuine, sincere ladies. That's huge. So I got so excited because I said, you know, everybody needs to know about this agency because I couldn't find another honest agency in Ukraine. So I said, everybody needs to know about this. And the bottom line is, I joined forces with them. We partnered up. We've rebranded as Match Guaranty with a Y.com. And we've done some incredible things differently because I realize in this industry especially, we need to earn your trust. You know, we need to do something different to give you a chance to check us out, right? To feel what we're all about and check out our ladies. So what we've done is we offer some incredible free services So you get to, like I say, check us out completely free. So what that includes is you get to meet up to 10 ladies. We'll personally introduce you to them, send them up to 20 emails, and you get to talk to one lady on Skype completely free. Okay, so that said, that's Match Guarantee with Y.com. On a final parting note, guys, I just want to say that I've been where you are right now. You know, I know what you're going through. I've taken the lumps. I've learned through the school of hard knocks, and I've paved the path for your success. Okay, how about we go on this journey together? Let me help you find your half in the Ukraine. I promise you it's possible. She's waiting for you here. That said, as always, the ball's in your court, right? So if that sounds good to you, go ahead. You can go to matchguaranteewithay.com and start your journey today. Okay, so on that note, I wish you all the best on your journey looking for love in the Ukraine. Bye now.